Richard, with all of this, right, yeah. you're awarded already, you're multi-platinum. I can imagine that there's a lot of money that you've also gained from this. And we're not going to talk about amounts, don't worry. The principle is, when it comes to the money that you have made, what general mindset do you have in dealing with money?
Pinaka-simple siguro is spend less than what you earn and then do it for a long, long time. One time, I think a friend talked to me and said, my dad, he earned so much. And ako din sabi ko, yeah, I know some people like that. But towards the end, they lose it. So I think a lot of people, when they get the money, they become a little bit engrossed in a luxurious lifestyle to the point that a tragedy happens or an unforeseen hump comes along. Eventually, they cannot sustain what they have put themselves to. They've increased their lifestyle to a stage where hindi na nila mababa or something like that. So I think that's kind of dangerous. So,
okay. So
I try to avoid a lifestyle that's way above.
When it comes to the mindset, you said spend less than what you make, right? Do you actually set aside that margin and invest it, or do you have someone doing it for you?
In my faith, parang I give a certain percentage to
the
tithe. Church, the tithe. I also give offerings, which is above the tithe, especially to world missions, because I believe that I think at one point I had no money, and then somebody gave me money. And I was so angry. I was so angry at my friend. I said to Erickson, by the way, who's my manager now.
He's the one that gave you the money?
He was the channel.
Okay.
So somebody gave money to Erickson to give to me, and I was like dead broke. And then I said to Erickson, I was so angry. I said, Erickson, why did you tell our friend in the States that I had no money? And so she gave this amount. And Erickson said, hey, why don't you call her now? You know what the girl says? I'm praying here in the States. God told me to give you this much.
Wow.
I was like, I cried. I was like, and I just cried so hard. And after crying, I just felt this light bulb that somebody cares for me so much to provide for me even from foreign land. So when I paid off my debts finally in 2007, I started giving to world missions even years before. Parang when I experienced ko yun, I said I have to give back because doon ako pinrovide internationally. And it's funny because I never thought I'd achieve this much in the Philippines, and then now they're sending me to like Hong Kong,
different parts of the world.
So I'm like, oh, this is it, you know. So I think when you give internationally, it also comes back internationally. So I think that's something powerful that, I don't know, I think it works.
You said you came to a point where you were very desperate and bankrupt, because here I am hearing your philosophy, right? And you're saying for the most part, you never went into that luxurious lifestyle. How did you end up in that situation?
It's funny because I grew up, I think most Chinese tingin nila lagi tayo may pera, no? But not true. I grew up in a middle class, well-off family, middle class. But somewhere along the way, I ran away from home. That's the best financial nugget that I got. Kasi when I ran away from home, it made me understand the difficulty of how to earn money. Those 7 years were like teaching me na, hey, I had this free before at home, and I never took it for granted.